Welcome to the Techno-Digital School. Many colleagues used to ask me the following. Miguel, I don't know how to create sets with my Python scripts in Abaqus. The sets are wrong, or I get errors whenever I change anything of the commands recorded. And every time my answer was, you're right, but sets are not the problem. The problem is the selection of geometry, faces, edges, or whatever. The Python commands recorded are not always valid when we modify the script, and sometimes we have to adapt them. So, in this video, I want to show you 5 ways to select geometry in Abaqus using Python commands in your scripts. The first way to select geometry is the default option recorded by Abaqus, using masks. Let's say that we have a rectangular part with one hole, and we create a set with the edge on the right. So we go to sets, double click, the name will be right, continue, and we select that edge. Done. If we record this operation, we will see that the Python commands looks like this. It has selected the right edge using the mask #4. This mask number has to do with the way in which Abaqus stores information in memory, and it is not very practical because it is not intuitive at all. We can use this command as long as the fundamental geometry doesn't change before. However, if we have 2 holes or make some partition before, the mask of the right edge will be different. That is the problem. So the question is, what else can we do to select that edge? We can use the function findAt. The syntax of this function is the following. Let's comment out this line, and now we are going to select that edge, the edge on the right, so we call it edges. We write e, so that is p.edges, as we can see up here, and then we write findAt, a in capital letter, and now we have to write 3 open parentheses. And now the coordinates, the x, y, z coordinates of a point with which we find that edge. So it could be a point in the middle of that right edge. So I will use the variables that I have defined at the beginning of the script. We can see them here. L is the length of the panel, and H is the height of the panel. So we can specify a point at the middle of this edge with coordinates L, H divided by 2, and 0 in the Z axis. We close the parentheses, put a comma and 2 more parentheses. So now we can save our script and test it in Abaqus. And in the sets, we will see that we have the set right here. This is the edge. And what if we want to select more than one edge? Let's say that our part is now this tube, defined by these parameters, the inner radius, the outer radius, the length of the tube, the thickness of the wall, and the mean radius. This one is the front face here, and on the back we would have the back face as well. And the origin of coordinates is at the center of the back face. Previously I have recorded a macro in which this command was obtained with this mask. However, then I have included some changes here to make some partitions, and the set obtained now from this script is the following. If we go to sets, here we can see this set front. It should contain all the faces on the front side of the tube. But since I have modified the geometry before, this mask does not correspond to those faces. So, as we have seen before, let's replace this selection of the geometry through a mask for the selection of the geometry with the function findAt. Faces equals p.faces.findAt. And now to select multiple faces, we are going to open two parentheses the coordinates of the first point to find the first face. So we could select a point over there. So x is rm, the mean radius. Then in the y direction, a small value could be 0.1 times rm. And finally, in the z axis, l, the length of the tube. Close parentheses, comma, close another parenthesis, and comma. And then we go to select the next point for the next face. So I will copy this, paste it here, and let's choose now the face below. Let's do the same with rm negative and y coordinate negative as well, duplicate, and now x negative, y positive. And this is the end. We have selected four points to find the four faces of the front side of the tube. So we can save the script, file, run script, and let's check the set, which is the set with all the faces on the front side of the tube. So this is how we can use the findAt function to select geometry. In this case, we have selected faces, but we could select edges, cells, etc., etc. The third method to select geometry is by using the getByBounding functions. This group of commands allow us to select all the geometrical entities into a particular volume, an orthogonal box with the getByBounding box, a cylinder with the getByBounding cylinder function, or a sphere with the getByBounding sphere. Let's say we want to select all the faces on the back side of the tube. So we would like to select these four faces on the back. So we can use the getByBounding box command. The syntax is similar to findAt, p.faces.getByBounding box. The arguments that we have to pass to this function are the coordinates of one of the corners of this imaginary box and the coordinates of the opposite corner. The first corner is the one with the smallest x, y, and z values, and the opposite corner is the one with the highest x, y, and z coordinates. So the x minimum could be outer radius minus a small value, for instance, 0.1. y minimum could be ro minus 0.1 as well, and z minimum could be minus 0.1. Any small value and negative, because the origin of coordinates of this part is at the center of the back face. And the x maximum is ro plus 0.1. Well, x minimum is minus ro, y minimum is minus ro, y max is ro plus 0.1. And z max is plus 0.1, for instance. Any positive value, not too long, otherwise it would select the whole cylinder, the whole tube. And like this, we have selected all the faces on the back side. Let's put it in a variable called faces. And let's copy paste these to create a new set that we will call back. Okay. We can apply the getByBounding cylinder to select, for instance, the inner faces of the tube. So let's write as well faces p.faces.getByBounding cylinder. And in this case, the arguments are the center of one of the bases of the cylinder, the imaginary cylinder, the center of the other, the second base, and the radius of the cylinder. So for center 1, we could say x0, y0, z minus 1, for instance, any value works fine. For center 2, we would have the same for x0, y0, and for z could be l plus some value. So we have some gap. And for the radius, we can say rm, a radius that is bigger than the inner radius and smaller than the outer radius. And again, we can copy this, paste it here, and say internal. Save it and test it. File, run script, run the script. Let's open the tree with Ctrl T and go to parts, tube, sets, back is here. Okay, it's fine. Front was fine as well, and internal are only the internal faces of the tube. As you can see, with these functions, with getByBounding cylinder or getByBounding box, we can save some time. It's sometimes shorter than using findAt. The fourth method to select geometrical entities is the use of Boolean operations. Let's say that we have our tube, as before. Let's display the isometric view. Okay, and let's say that we want to select to create a set with the outer cylindrical faces. For that, we could use findAt as well, but in this case, we're going to take this set with all the faces of the model, and we are going to subtract. We are going to apply a Boolean operation, subtracting the faces from the back, from the front, and from the internal sets, so that the only remaining faces are the external faces. So once we select all of them, right-click and click on Boolean. This is how we create a set from a Boolean operation in Abaqus CAI. There are multiple Boolean operation options. We are going to select difference, and the set from which we're going to subtract the rest of the sets is going to be all faces. Let's give it a name, external, for instance, and OK. And now we have the set external that only contains the faces on the outer surface of the tube. And the Python commands recorded, if we do this while recording a macro, would be this one. P is the part, and the operation is called setByBoolean. The function is setByBoolean. First, we provide a name, let's call it external, for instance. Then we specify the operation, the type of Boolean operation, which is a difference, it's a subtraction. And finally, we specify the sets on which we are going to apply this Boolean operation. So we take all faces, the first, the base set, and we subtract back, front, and internal is the name of the last set. Boolean operations are extremely useful in certain situations, in certain cases, and may save lots of time. And the final method to select geometry using Python commands is by filtering all the objects, all the edges, all the faces, all the vertices that we want to choose. For instance, let's say that we want to mesh our part, go to mesh, and we apply global seeds to our part, so we come here, seed part, and we select a size of 2 millimeters, okay. But in order to save computational time, the element size along the tube is going to be bigger. So for that, we're going to apply local seeds along these edges, along the longitudinal edges. So in Abaqus CAI, we would select seed edges, and select all of the edges. I will only check 2 of them, hit OK, and let's specify a different dimension. Let's say, in this case, 5 millimeters. OK. So let's replicate this in our script. If we record these operations, this global seeding and local seeding, we will get the following lines. We will get a line like this for the global seeding of the whole part with this function, seed part. And then we have this other function, seed edge by size. And here we have some edges selected that we have to find ourselves. So these edges selected is going to be a list of edges. And to identify those edges, we're going to loop through all of the edges of the part. For that, we are going to write for e in p.edges, colon, and how can we identify, how can we distinguish which are these longitudinal edges? Well, there are multiple ways, but in this case, the easiest is to ask for the size of the edges. So we could write e.getSize, and this function, this method, is going to give us the length of the edge. So let's put it in a variable, edge length. And if this edge length is equal to L, to the length of the whole tube, this is a longitudinal edge. So we can put it in our list. Like this, with the function append, we include this edge E. If it's not equal to L, we will skip this edge. So now we can save it. And let's run it. Remember, this edge selected comes into this function. We are going to apply this seed edge by size only to those edges. So let's go back to Abaqus. I will cancel this, file, run a script, run this script, and there it is. We can see that we have also meshed the model because we have this function here, p.generateMesh. And we can see very well the length of these elements. Actually, we can see the seeds as well in purple. These local seeds are purple, the global seeds are white. And like this, we conclude this video. We have seen 5 ways in which we can select geometry. And we've also learned what are the limitations of using masks to select geometry and then to create sets. See you in the next one. Bye.